My name is Karan Bharaj. I am doing a master's in mechanical engineering with a year in industry. I'm actually from Kenya and I will be working at Rolls Royce Plc, and my role is manufacturing engineering. I will be under the tier 2 visa after completion of my tier 4 student visa. How placement is looked at by Rolls Royce is that it's looked at as a 12-month interview. So if you stay in the same role, then you don't need to have another interview. Right. But if you decide to change over to like design engineering, then you have to go through an interview. So my performance was reviewed by my line manager. There's like a review board that reviews your performance and then lets you know whether you are successful in getting a job or not. I applied for about 15.
Yeah.
So I got invited to about 5 interviews. I got invited to 6, and the 6th interview was the one I got my job in. Yeah, right. So I failed 4 interviews before, right. And I had 2 offers then.
Okay.
So then I chose Rolls Royce and I told no to the other company. Yeah.
Brilliant.
So it came after a small degree of persistence.
Yeah.
After like failing 4, but I applied to about 15, and I applied to those which interest me. I think my success lied in the fact that I failed 4 times. So I sort of, one thing I'll say, most people tend to fail an interview at some point. The most important thing is make sure you get feedback after you fail, so you know where you've gone wrong. So that's what I did. When I got feedback, it became apparent to me that it's very important to research on the companies that you are looking to apply to. I know people who who have 1 cover letter, 1 CV for 5 or 6 different companies, and they just change the name and they submit that. That's not a very good idea.
No.
I would recommend probably spending about a good amount of time on the company that interests you the most, and really researching on them. What makes them unique and what are they looking for, like reading something like their annual report or something like that.
Yeah.
On doing so, I think that really makes a difference, because these companies get like thousands of applications in. The thing I did in my first 3 years was try to keep myself busy I was on holidays. So over my summer holidays, if I went back home, I would try and do some engineering related placement.
Yeah.
Even whilst I was at university, I sort of worked part-time in HMV as a sales assistant.
Nice.
Just I know it's not engineering related, but still it was just to get a feel of the working life. And in my first 2 years, I was sort of like the international engineering ambassador. I would highly recommend people to do that, because they give you a lot of freedom to do the sort of project that you want to do. So I decided to do some like university tours, some presentations about how life is at university. In my 3rd year, I decided to do Engineering Without Borders.
Mm.
And the reason I decided to do this is because I already spent like 2 years in university and I didn't really make anything, like design and made anything. So I decided let me try and do Engineering Without Borders, because you get a chance to actually build something from scratch.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's really good. I highly recommend students to do that, new students coming in. And besides that, I also took part in a meet and greet as a deputy coordinator, which is really great, because university is about like meeting different people from different cultures and that sort of stuff.
Yeah.
So I'll highly recommend students to do that as well. So that was sort of the rationale behind the extracurricular activities that I decided to take. The one in particular I used was reviewing my cover letter and CV.
Yeah.
So that was really helpful. I got really good advice on how I should structure my CV, how I should portray what I want to portray in my cover letter.
Yeah.
So that was very important, because these kind of things, you need to be concise, and yet you need to make sure that you declare your message.
Yeah.
Tell the company what you actually are about. So that was really helpful in particular. And also searching for jobs, that was really good as well, because your website, it brings up notifications, email notifications every now and again. So that's extremely helpful. Yeah.
Did you go to many employer presentations or careers fairs, that sort of thing?
Yes, I did. Yeah, I did go to career fairs. I went to employer presentations as well, like the ones I was interested in, because I was looking for jobs like in aerospace or automotive. So I went to the relevant ones, yes. Yeah. But again, those notifications are very helpful, because they always keep you posted on what's coming up. I'd say first things are ask yourself what your interests are. Yeah, what sort of like excites you? Why are you doing engineering? Is it like, do you like making things? Do you like designing things? And I'd say at the university, there's almost like, I know people like who like cars, they do stuff like formula student. So that always helps, because when it comes down to employability, really what employers are looking for are enthusiastic people. So if you're enthusiastic about what you do, chances are that you will get the job. So they're looking for those kind of people. If you don't know what you're doing, really, it's worth trying out different things.